So happy St. Patrick's Day. We are in the kitchen. We're making one of my favorite foods today. I'm with Chef Jack Doherty from Doherty's Pub, and we are making shepherd's pie.
Yep.
This is my favorite comfort food. So we're gonna go through some of the ingredients.
Sure.
So what do we have here? Because this is something that I feel like, is this a difficult dish to make?
No, no. You probably have every ingredient at home in every household.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So what do we have here?
We got
all this deliciousness.
We got some kernel corn right here. Mashed potatoes, red bliss mashed potatoes.
Okay.
Ground beef.
Now, do you have to use the red bliss, or is
no,
that
I just
your
prefer I just prefer red bliss. Has a little more flavor.
Okay.
But
cool.
You can use any mashed potato, whatever your favorite mashed potato recipe will work fine.
Perfect.
Brown gravy.
Okay.
Some Worcestershire sauce, granulated garlic, celery salt, and seasoning salt, mm-hmm. and onions.
Now, is this a staple recipe, or is this like, do you just pull in pieces that you feel are going to add better flavors?
Is this? No, this is pretty staple. Well, some people add like corn, besides the corn, some people add carrots and peas.
Oh, they do? Okay,
yeah. I'm a traditionalist. I like just corn.
Now, on St. Patrick's Day, how many of these do you think that you will actually serve?
Hundreds.
Really?
Literally hundreds. It's a great base.
It is a great base.
It's a great
absolutely,
base. It's
absolutely.
A great comfort food. People come in and get it, and they love it.
Now, do you find this is like a true comfort food for people? Because this is why I love it.
Oh, it's under our menu on comfort food.
Is it really?
Yeah, that's what it's
I did not know that. That was totally me just asking that. So now, especially for the ground beef, because that's something that I love. But how much do you usually use?
There's about 8 ounces in each order, so there's enough here to do 3 orders.
Okay.
But you could whatever size your casserole dish that you're going to put it in to bake in the oven, you can just adjust it accordingly.
Oh, I'm very excited for this. I'm very excited to try this out. But no, I definitely feel like, especially the onions, being pregnant to myself, can you put more or less
in? Oh, you can do whatever you want. That nice thing about shepherd's pie is, you know, the mashed potatoes cut everything. You put anything you want underneath.
Oh, I can't wait. Okay, so stay tuned, because we're going to be making this delicious dish with Jack Doherty very soon.
But for now, back to the kitchen. Michaela?
All right, Meg, we were smelling it earlier, and now we're going to talk about what we're doing. Chef Jack Doherty from Doherty's Pub is joining us. You got a great Irish meal
mm-hmm.
going on today.
Very simple.
Remind everyone what we're making.
We're making some shepherd's pie.
Okay. And I was mentioning this pan before. I don't know if you can see it at home, but it looks extremely nonstick. And I got to say, it's probably helpful when you're cooking up meat like
it's
this.
It's great. It makes it easier. You know, it's easy to clean up afterwards, too, so it's awesome.
Okay. So tell us a little bit about what you've done here.
So far, we've taken the onions, and we've already sweated those.
Mm-hmm.
Cooked them for about 2-3 minutes. Then we just browned the ground beef. We already put our seasoning there. And it's a very simple dish. It literally takes about 15, 20 minutes to make at home.
Now, because this is ground beef, I'm sure it's going to cook up fast, so
mm-hmm.
you should suggest probably not leaving this one and coming back to it.
No, you don't want to leave this in simmer for a while. Yeah, you got to just keep stirring it. Then you're going to drain the grease off, because you don't want the grease to affect the flavor of it too much.
Okay.
So you want to use like an 85-15 mix, because you want a little flavor from the fat in there.
What do you mean by 85-15?
On the ground beef.
Okay.
You know, you get 93% of it, but you want to get about 85-88%, just because it's going to give you a lot of flavor. And then it's very simple after that. You just add a little beef gravy.
Yum.
A little Worcestershire sauce.
And I'm sure this is going to be on your menu this weekend, right?
Oh, we're going to sell hundreds of these this weekend.
Yeah.
Some corn. Or some people like putting carrots and peas in it.
Yeah, I think that's nice with shepherd's pie. Our cameraman here was just mentioning, too, he's made this with ground turkey.
You can make
before.
It with turkey. You can do that. You can. The nice thing is you can substitute a lot of these things. You know, I like corn. I'm a traditionalist, but some people really love peas and carrots. I'm not
mm-hmm.
a big peas and carrots guy, but people who love it, you can put anything you want in this, and then you just top it with the potatoes. You're going to put it in a casserole dish, and away you go.
I like that. It's the versatility of it. It also saves you from making maybe another trip to the market. If you have one thing in the house and not the other, you can kind of mix and match.
And it's easy to reheat the next day. I mean, you make this, this is one of those meals that really gets better the next day.
That's true. I got to tell you, my sister and my dad, this is probably their top meal of the day. So I'm sure they're drooling back at home watching this. We're going to finish it up a little later in the show. Back to you. Back in the Rhode Show kitchen, tip of the morning to ya. We're making an Irish dish with Chef Jack Doherty from Doherty's Pub. I promise. My Irish accent is done. No, we're done.
I love it.
Chef, what are we making today?
Shepherd's pie.
Shepherd's pie. We already browned the meat. Mm-hmm. Audrey, you were saying that this is one of your favorites.
It is. I love it. It's just one of those things, especially too, like during a snowstorm. I used to love to just like curl up with a little dish. But you know, my Nana used to make it, and I've never tried it. So watching you today, this is really inspiring me to want to go home and do this.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
All right. So where do we stand now?
Everything's all ready. We're going to put the meat in the casserole.
Okay.
And then we're going to take that, and then we're going to top with our mashed potatoes.
So these don't have to be hot.
No, because we're going to pop them in the oven for about 15 minutes.
Okay.
You know, and you want to use a nice, sturdy dish that can handle the oven. Don't put it in a regular bowl, otherwise you have bad things
crack.
Happen to you.
You don't want.
See, I would have done that. You had to say that.
Audrey's taking notes over there. Now, if you don't have a fancy little dish like this, what can you use?
Any oven safe product was fine. You know, a little casserole dish of any type.
Could you make a bigger one for
your whole family?
You could, and just spoon it out. We just do them individual at the restaurant. Right. It makes it a lot easier.
Oh, is this how they come?
This is how they come. Yeah. This is how you see. What you see is what you get.
Great.
You take mashed potatoes, and you want to be.
I love it. My favorite.
You want to be liberal with the mashed potatoes.
I noticed too that you kept the skins on your mashed potatoes.
We do.
I enjoy that. Not everyone does. Mm-hmm. So again, this is a dish you can personalize.
Yeah, very very personalized.
Look at how good that looks. It's like the frosting.
Already you
the frosting right on top.
Eat it up.
And you just take that.
And that's
okay.
It.
And that's it. Simple, simple.
Mm-hmm. We pop it in the oven.
Pop in the oven.
Time and temp, chef. And
350 degrees, 15 minutes until the potatoes
not
brown
bad.
On top.
Okay, you know, but so that's right, because we already cooked the meat.
Yeah, everything's all cooked. You're pretty much just reheating everything there. You can make these in advance and then pop them in the oven afterwards. They'll heat up in about 20 minutes.
Would you ever sprinkle cheese on top, or you think that would ruin it?
You could. I mean, like I said, this is.
Can you tell I'm craving cheese?
Yeah,
you
can do anything. You can do anything you want with this dish. That's what makes it awesome.
Beautiful,
which is great.
And you have one that has been in there.
We do.
I just got a sneak peek. Looks so good.
It does. And you know, it's really nice when you get that golden brown crust.
It's perfect.
On the
top.
At that. Now that is beautiful. You talked about how this was at your restaurant. Gotta be popular, especially this weekend.
Especially this weekend. It's a good base. You know, people might be enjoying a few libations this weekend for St. Patrick's Day.
Yeah, and, a few.
And then, so this is, you know, we serve a ton of these. They're quick, they're easy, they're a quick meal to eat. Mm-hmm. They come with two sides, so people really enjoy them.
Now, the standard bite, do you prefer everything in one bite?
I do. I want all the flavors mixed together. Some people do. It's a science. Some people pick it apart. You know, some people put ketchup on it, which I'm a big no-no on.
I love it. My sister-in-law would be with you. She can't stand ketchup, but I could see that.
Definitely. And you actually mentioned you have multiple locations.
Yeah, we do. We have Shannonview Inn in Warwick. We have Doherty's East Ave in Pawtucket, Sullivan's in Pawtucket, and Sullivan's in Warwick.
And I'm sure they're all going to be hopping for St. Patty's Day.
This is the holy week for us.
You guys start preparing now?
We started cooking corned beef like 2 weeks ago, actually.
Wow,
we go
goodness.
Through about 1,200 cooked pounds, which is about 2,400 pounds of raw product.
So you got shepherd's pie, you got corned beef and cabbage, and what are some other traditional Irish dishes?
Bangers and mash, which is an Irish sausage.
Oh, that's right. Bangers and mash. What is bangers and mash?
Bangers is just a mild Irish sausage. I mean, and mashed potatoes, and usually caramelized onions. But it's very popular.
I always see that on the menu. I don't really know.
Yeah, it's just a sausage.
I don't really know enough
about what
it is.
But what would be your go-to?
Shepherd's pie.
This would be your go-to over everything.
Good base. Beef stew, too. Beef stew.
Beef stew would be delicious.
Beef stew, but shepherd's pie, it's quick, it's easy, it's delicious.
Okay, that smell. It smells so good.
It does smell really good. I don't know. I think you got a fork in there. Let's at least, carve into this.
There's a spoon over here. I want to see what it looks like inside.
We got to see the inside of this. Oh, did you hear that?
Yeah, I did. Nice crunch. I feel like I'm on the Food Network. I'm like, a nice crunch. It looks delicious. Look at that.
Do you see the inside of that?
Looks great.
Beautiful.
Got all the layers right there.
Piping hot. And like you said, if you don't eat it all, you can save it for leftovers, too.
True.
All right. If you want this recipe, head on over to WPRI.com.